my colleagues in Lucknow. Lucknow is not new for me. Many of you might be new, who might not have been introduced with me. I lived in Lucknow for about 45 years. Still my heart and soul is here. If anybody asks me about any CME in Lucknow, I leave every job and come to Lucknow. So that what has actually happened. Well, thank you, Jan, for the nice introduction. As you know that you have all collected here for Indravaram Ambalal Modi Innovation Conclave, what in short you call it as IMICON. Let me say a few words about, although in my presentation probably a few words will come, but let me say a few words about Mr. Modi. You know, being a pulmonologist, when I look this subject for last 40 years, the two things which are really either destroy the lung or killing the patient, one is TB. Many of you, all of you must have seen TB. I still remember one of the instances that let me quote here, when I was director in SAFRI, about I think maybe a year, more than a year back, our chief minister, since he belongs to that place, Sri Akhilesh Yadav, he came to our institute. And he had some relative who was ill for some respiratory problem. So he came to respiratory diseases. I being the director, there were 63 patients when he visited that ward. I still remember vividly, it was evening time, about 6:30. He asked me, and he said, let me say his words. Sir, he said like this, he is a very humble person. Sir, I have heard that you are a great chest physician. But all the 63 patients, including my whom I came here to see, they are all crying. They are having breathlessness. And they are saying that they are not responding. तो सर अगर आपसे नहीं ठीक हो सकते तो किससे ठीक होंगे? हमने कहा ये किसी से नहीं ठीक हो सकते, क्योंकि मैंने कहा अखिलेश जी दो बातें, अभी आज भी मेरी किसी से बात हो रही थी, दो मरीज हमारे सैफई के अभी पटेल चेस्ट में भर्ती हैं ऐसे ही, हमने कहा दो चीजें इस इलाके की बड़ी कमजोरी है, आपका इलाका है, ये आपको ठीक करना है. एक तो लोग यहाँ बीड़ी पीते हैं. That causes lung cancer, which is, you have heard, practically most fatal neoplastic disease of the human being. Second, हमने कहा आधे मरीज तीन चौथाई इसमें टीबी वाले लेते हैं जिन्होंने दवा ठीक से नहीं किया, तभी इनके फेफड़े खराब हो गए. अब इसमें कुछ नहीं किया जा सकता है, इनकी सांस ऐसे ही फूलती रहेगी. हमने कहा लंग कैंसर वाले वो तो मर गए, और जो बीड़ी जिन्होंने पिया, हमने यहाँ तक कह दिया ह्यूमरस टोन में, हमने कहा आपके परिवार में भी बहुत लोग बीड़ी पीते हैं, मुझसे आके मिलते तो मैं सबसे पहले यही कहता हूँ भैया बीड़ी छोड़ दो, चाचा जी बीड़ी छोड़ दो, या ताऊ जो भी. सो आई मीन दीज टू डिजीजेस हैज मेड रैम्पेंट, हैज मेड एवरीथिंग, हैज डिस्ट्रॉयड द लंग, किलिंग पीपल. I'm happy that Modi ji at least has been associated with both the diseases. You know, I'll just narrate the story about the resurrection when I'll say my talk, but at least he was really icon, I must say that, towards innovation and excellence in the Indian science. I met him, I have the opportunity to meet him personally, maybe about, if I remember, 7-8 times. But two of the meetings I still remember. One meeting was very official, means when I was invited from, I was in KGMC in 2009. I hope I still remember that when this Rajarin was dedicated to the nation. And it was no one other than, you must have seen, Mr. Sameer, Dr. Sameer Brahmachari, who is director of CSIR today. And because this product was developed with the help of, this was a PPM model, government sector and the private, they both Modi ji and CSIR, they have collaborated. So CSIR director came there to inaugurate that, and I was one of the speakers in that. And when I finished my lecture, Modi ji came to me personally and said, sir, because my first slide at that time was 500,000 of patients are dying with tuberculosis. I'm talking 2009. This figure will change when you see my presentation. So he came to me, said, "Itne log TB se marte hain sahab, humne ko aur kya?" Bole, "Doctor sahab, humne ek dawa to nikali hai, koshish kari hai, dekhiye aap log isse aage badhaye." And whatever evidences has been shown at that time in 2009, I still remember, I said to Modi, drug is very good. If what is being done by 450 milligram, if by combining some indigenous thing, if can be reduced to 200 milligram, so first it is a very welcome step, but it needs more and more studies. I'm happy to inform, immediately after meeting me, he has already sanctioned a multi-site project. Lucknow was one of the sites, I think the study has just finished. There are 7-8 sites throughout the country, and that would be phase 4 trial, I believe. And still I think they are analyzing, and the results will be communicated. So what I'm trying to see, he was really a very passionate person. The second visit I still remember very vividly. I went to Mount Abu for this Brahma Kumari's function. Anyway, while turning back, since I have known by that time Modi ji, I went to see. So he is very cordial. I still remember my wife was with me, and he came, received us. He took lunch with us in their corporate area. So that was a few things which still makes the person great. So with these few things about Dr. Modi, I will be with you for next 10 minutes. And I will be dealing something with the scenario of TB globally and India. And this is a Patel chest, which many of you have heard. I have joined as director. This is an institute. This is the, you know, old politicians have a great vision. This was established in 1949, when everybody talked about TB, TB, TB. But it's Jawaharlal Nehru's and Vallabhbhai Patel venture and dream. In 1949, they thought about a chest disease. In KGMC, I thought about chest disease, I believe, in 1980s onwards, we have started changing everything. But they thought, way back in 50s and early 50s, and they started this institute with the mandate of first research, then medical education. We run all the three courses, BTCD, MD, DM, pulmonary medicine. Then we run allied MD courses like physiology, pharmacology. You must have heard name of Professor Pintel. He was director for many long years. Pharmacology, microbiology, pathology. So with this, and then the patient care. I cannot forget these two institutes. KGMC, where I said I lived for about 41 years. I entered in this campus in 1970 as a medical student, and I left this campus in 2011 and to join as a director. You cannot imagine that this below diagram, it is situated in the rural areas. Gaon ke andar hai. Can anybody could believe? I think the photograph is better than KGMC. Sometimes I believe. Forget it. Totally air conditioned. I lived for about 18 months. I can't remember any day जिस दिन लाइट चली गई हो वहां पर. उसके बाद जब मैं लखनऊ आता था तो अपनी वाइफ से कहता था, भैया अब मैं नहीं आऊंगा, अब मैं वहीं चलता, चलो वहीं चलो, यहाँ नहीं रहना, यहाँ लाइट ज्यादा कटती. और कोई दिन कहता नहीं. सो व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से, बट जवाहरलाल नेहरू सॉ द ड्रीम ऑफ पटेल, मोदी जी सॉ द ड्रीम ऑफ इंडियन कंपनीज मेकिंग इंडियन ड्रग्स अफोर्डेबल ड्रग्स. श्री मुलायम सिंह सॉ ए ड्रीम ऑफ having an institute in a rural area. So, you know, if you have a commitment, if you have a thinking, you can do anything. That I was trying to see. So with these, I just focused his photograph, which I got it today. That true celebration of research, said his words, lies as much in inventions as in making the medicine affordable to the last man in the society, which you are healing, which you have seen in the picture. When I say about TB, I always, this slide I made in 1980 when I became lecturer, and I made it from the, let me confess, because at that time I had very little experience. But I still love to talk about this slide, and I say that TB is 100% curable. In 80s, these sentences I made from book. But now I can say with a very good confidence, after treating thousands and thousands of patients of tuberculosis, that really it is a 100% curable disease. Only two things. You should prescribe well, and not only prescribe well, you should make your patient to take those medications. If these two things are met, I have treated tuberculosis like this thousands and thousands. I made them. और डॉक्टर साहब मैं एक बार बताऊं, सब डॉक्टर ही लोग हैं. कैंसर वाला हमने थोड़ा सी काम काल किया, जब लोग करीब आनो 90s में सब मर गए, कोई जिंदा नहीं है जो आके बैठ चुके हैं. समझ गए? अस्थमा वाले की बीच बीच में सांस फूलती है, डरता है बताते हैं. सीओपीडी वाला वो भी अल्टीमेटली जाएगा जाएगा. एक सिर्फ टीबी का आदमी बचता है. और वही लोग जहां भी हम लोग जाते हैं, ट्रेन में, बस में, बैंक में, किसी मेडिकल कॉलेज में, तो लोग बात करके आके बैठ. आई मीन दिस इज 100% क्यूरेबल, दिस इज व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से. बट अनफॉर्चुनेटली इंडिया स्टैंड्स लार्जेस्ट नंबर ऑफ टीबी इन इंडिया. नॉट ओनली टीबी, there is a drug resistance. There is a very dreaded drug resistance. MDR-TB, globally, you know, about 450,000 MDR-TB arising every year. Believe me, the disease which is 100% curable. We are, in India also, it is estimated about 1 lakh patients of MDR-TB every year. And 92, and we have not stopped here. XDR-TB. Further resistance. 92 countries has already reported. This is 2013 report of global TB report. 9.6 of MDR, they are XDR TB. At least 10%. In 4,050,000. So about 45,000 to 50,000 cases every year. XDR-TB is not only in Western, there are a lot of reports from India, including KGMC figures. TDR, now people have started reporting total drug resistance. So what I'm trying to say, and you know, not only this, good news is, in 2009, when I delivered my lecture in front of Sri Modi ji, I said about 5 lakhs, because at that time, now, good news is, 2 lakh 20,000 instead of 5, it is 220.
But still, so many people are dying.
In 10-15 minutes, I will talk to you. More than 15 people will die with tuberculosis. Let me say why, and I say in one line. Here it is a poor control practices. When I say poor control practices, what I mean? Control practices are very scientifically driven, but their management may not be. Kabhi doctor nahi, kabhi dawa nahi, kabhi x-ray nahi, kabhi kuch nahi. So I said, and this is all management issues. This is not the science issue. Science is well behind every control program. Clinical practices. I have seen, still sitting in my VPCI OPD, day before, rather yesterday, Friday, I have seen a prescription which I cannot share with you, of TB. I'm talking of Delhi. That is still poor clinical practices as far as TB diagnostics and treatment is concerned. And I say, why this is happening? As a teacher, I say, fault is mine. Fault is ours. We have not been able to educate our younger generation, our doctors, so that, because I know, I'm a personal opinion, nobody would like to that his patient should not be well. Kai mareej mujhse aate hain, kehte hain, "Are sir, wo doctor saab ne to bada bada kar diya, unne aisa kar diya." Are maine kaha, "Yaar tum kya baat kar rahe ho? ये बताओ, ऐसा कोई डॉक्टर एक बता दो जो मुझे ये बता दो कि ऐसा भी कोई डॉक्टर होगा जो ये चाहेगा कि तुम हमारा मरीज ठीक ना हो." बट इट इज लैक ऑफ एजुकेशन, इट इज अ लैक ऑफ नॉलेज, इट इज द इग्नोरेंस. सो आई ऑलवेज से एट द गवर्नमेंट, नाउ आई एम सिटिंग नियर द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट, आई यूज टू से ओनली सोल्यूशन फॉर गुड टीबी कंट्रोल अपार्ट फ्रॉम अदर थिंग्स इज अ गुड मेडिकल एजुकेशन in medical colleges and in other places. So that's why this is happening. Let me say in 1 or 2 minutes how TB is diagnosed today. TB diagnosis, I'll not go into details, whether you do tuberculin test, whether you do IGRA, QuantiFERON, GOLD, they are all gives you the information about prevalence of infection, no disease. हमने देखा है, रोज हम पे पर्चे आते हैं, भानु पे भी आते होंगे, टेस्ट करा लिया, पॉजिटिव आ गया, टीबी दवाई ली. सो दीज आर द मिस्टेक्स व्हाट वी आर फेसिंग. बैक्टीरियोलॉजी नो डाउट इज अ गोल्ड स्टैंडर्ड. रेडियोलॉजी ऑल्दो इट इज वेरी स्पेसिफिक, ऑल्दो इट इज वेरी सेंसिटिव, बट स्पेसिफिसिटी इज नॉट वेरी हाई. यू कैन सी द शैडो बट यू कैन नॉट टेल वेदर टीबी नॉन टीबी. इम्यूनोलॉजिकल, लेट मी इन्फॉर्म ऑल ऑफ यू, मस्ट हैव ऑलवेज बीन इन्फॉर्म दैट इम्यूनोलॉजिकल टेस्ट हैज बीन बैंड. We are shouting for last 15 years, but I am happy last year WHO and Government of India has banned this test. Histopathology, molecular biology, lot of hope with these tests, either for diagnosis of TB or for diagnosis of MDR-TB. Bronchoscopy, other tests may help. So this is how you diagnose. MDR-TB, how you diagnose? Basically, you diagnose by either by culture sensitivity or by molecular. But still, culture sensitivity and molecular biology, lot of standardization, lot of problem we see in our day-to-day practice. And if you get culture sensitivity done, although this is a gold standard, I can talk you for hours and hours. एक पेशेंट आता है, उसके बाद तीन रिपोर्टें होती हैं, तीनों कल्चर सेंसिटिविटी की होती हैं, तीन बड़े अच्छे लैब भी होते हैं, लेकिन तीनों की अलग अलग रिपोर्टें. सो नॉट दैट व्हाट इज अ गोल्ड स्टैंडर्ड इन दिस कंट्री मे ऑलवेज बी अ गोल्ड स्टैंडर्ड. सो यू हैव टू यूज योर माइंड, यू हैव टू यूज योर, दिस इज हाउ यू डायग्नोज एमडीआर टीबी. लीवर टेस्ट लाइक लिक्विड लाइन प्रोवेसेस, ये नया टेस्ट जिसके बारे में आपने सुना होगा, एक्सपर्ट एमडी रिफ. आप पता है कि 100 मिनट्स में टीबी डायग्नोज कर देता है, और 100 मिनट्स में अगर रिफैम्पिसिन रेजिस्टेंस है तो एमडीआर टीबी डायग्नोज कर देता है. लेकिन इसके भी अपने कुछ प्रॉब्लम्स, आई नॉट गोइंग टू डिटेल्स. ओनली वन थिंग आई, क्योंकि आप लोग जितने भी सभी लोग आधे ज्यादा प्रैक्टिशनर होंगे, ये टेस्ट आजकल करा रहे हैं, क्योंकि लैब वाले बहुत तेजी से पुश कर रहे हैं इस टेस्ट को. Only thing you have to remember that if the pre-test probability, you see the red line, is 2%, means where chance of MDR-TB is low, then its positive predicted value is only 50%. So if you have got gene expert which says rifampicin resistance and pre-test probability is not very high, that 50% chance it may be MDR, it may not be an MDR. So beware while taking these tests. And if the pre-test probability is 15%, it means there is a probability for MDR-TB, then positive predictive value may be 90-95%. So that's the thing you have to understand. Now, next 1.5 minutes on how TB is treated. Although I take this lecture for full 1 hour, but I will just say in about 90 minutes how TB is treated today. TB treatment has been made very simple. We have to remember only 4 regimens. And that is, what are 4 regimens? Means first, if any patient comes to you, you should decide whether he is a new case. You know the definition of new case. New case means person who has not taken any treatment or taken maximum 4 weeks of treatment, and then first time diagnose whether pulmonary, whether extrapulmonary. Then treatment of previously treated. Somebody who took more than 4 weeks of treatment, he becomes previously treated. Now in this group, it may be a simple case where you can try 5 drug regimen where chances of MDR and XDR is low. Or it may be case of MDR or XDR. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4 regimen. Log likh kitna rahe hain? Hamari ek study publish hui thi 2004 mein International Journal of TB and Lung Disease mein, isi shahar ki, isi pradesh ki. 36 regimen. Kahan se aate hain? Hum doctor ke paas, hum aksar yehi kehte hain. हम डॉक्टरों के पास दिमाग बहुत है. प्लीज डोंट मिस यूज दैट माइंड इन मेकिंग द रेजिमेन. देयर आर स्टैंडर्ड रेजिमेन. मोर देन 95% ऑफ द पेशेंट यू हैव टू चूज वन ऑफ देम. इन 5% इन अ डिफिकल्ट सीन यू मे डू एनीथिंग, यू आर अलाउड. बट इन 95% प्लीज डोंट डेविएट. एंड व्हाट आर दोज रेजिमेन? स्टार्ट विद 4 ड्रग फॉलोड बाय 2 ड्रग. This is 6 months standard, or you may give 3 drug in the continuation phase if INH resistance is high. Second regimen, pahla regimen wo hua. Dusra kya hua? 5 drug, category 2 wala. Streptomycin, INH rifampicin, paraquat ethambutol, followed by 1 month of 4 drug, followed by 5 months of 3 drug. Total is 8 to 9 months. MDR, agar kuch aap log ilaj karte ho, please. We just finished a study of how people are writing for MDR-TB. Horrible. That is why so many people are dying. Horrible. I cannot explain to you. Abhi wo study puri hui, hamari analysis chal rahi hai. Horrible. Kisi ne ek dawa likh di, kisi ne do likh di. Jiski jo, and only it is because of, again I say, who are teaching and training. I don't have time to explain. But what I am trying to say, injection of 6 mahine lagte hain. 5 साल पहले मैंने एक मरीज को लिख दिया, 5 महीने सुई, तो दवा की दुकान वाला इतना सेंसिबल था इसी लखनऊ के अंदर, उन्होंने कहा यार डॉक्टर साहब हैं तो बड़े अच्छे, लेकिन कुछ गलती हो रही है, सुई तो 90 लगते हैं, ये नहीं, हम नहीं देंगे तुम्हें सुई, जाके पूछ क्या ही केम. सो थिंग्स आर चेंजिंग. व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से, now injection is minimum 6 maximum 9 months. You have started a MDR treatment regimen. Kanamycin is given for 6 to 9 months. This is all evidence based. 2011 guidelines say like this, and then many drugs, and for 4 years there is a regimen for XDR-TB where injection is for 6 months to 1 year, and treatment is for 2.5 to 3 years. So these are the difficult scenario what I am trying to say. Let me say one slide on this regimen. One slide. What I'm trying to, what I was being, when I took the lecture of At that time when this product was inaugurated, one thing clicked to my mind which I like to share with you, that this is a, piparin is a kali mirch. In utni kali mirch aap kha nahi sakte jisse 10 milligram lag jaye. Kali mirch bahut pehle se use hota tha, hum log kisi dimag mein aaya nahi. But now it has been, they have, Modi ji and his team has proven that it is a bioenhancer. It can bioenhance availability of many drugs including rifampicin. So this basic principle they have used, and this is the one thing that if the below red line is 200 milligram rifampicin, so concentration is, bioavailability is very low, and this is the black line is of conventional 450, and that another red line near black line is the conventional say rifampicin 200 and addition of this indigenous thing jisko hum roz khate hain. Maine ek sawal us time pucha tha jo Atal sahab aaye us time, maine kaha bhai kitni kali 10 milligram, bole sahab itne mein milega itne आप खा नहीं सकते. सो दे हैव एक्सट्रैक्टेड. सो दिस इज अ गुड थिंग, दे हैव एट लीस्ट थॉट, दे हैव प्रूवन अप टू फेज 3 ट्रायल. फेज 4 ट्रायल इज ऑलरेडी देयर एंड मेनी पीपल हैव ऑलरेडी यूज्ड इट. वी हैव यूज्ड इट, वी आर पार्ट ऑफ दैट स्टडी एंड वी फाउंड दैट ड्रग इज वेरी इफेक्टिव, एज इफेक्टिव एज 450 मिलीग्राम रिफैम्पिसिन. सो दैट्स द फ्यूचर ड्रग. आई थिंक डॉक्टर साहब विल स्पीक अबाउट द फ्यूचर ड्रग. ओनली वन थिंग आई वुड लाइक टू से, लॉट ऑफ फ्यूचर ड्रग्स आर पाइपलाइन. वन ऑफ द ड्रग नोन एज बीटाक्विलिन, आई अटेंडेड दिस बीटाक्विलिन मीटिंग अबाउट अ वीक बैक इन इंडियन काउंसिल ऑफ मेडिकल रिसर्च. आई बीइंग द डायरेक्टर इज पार्ट ऑफ दैट कमिटी, एंड वी आर ऑल्दो इट दिस ड्रग हैज बीन अप्रूव्ड बाय एफडीए on 28 December 2012, about a year back, but in India still it is not available. But we are thinking, because in India, what is your problem? Jaisi drug aayi, sara doctor bidaquilin likhna shuru kar dega, and the drug will be lost. So the government of India, we as a scientist are already churning over it. How to use this drug? So there will be, time will come that you will be told. Although WHO has defined the indication when it should be used, but in India we have to define. So these are the new drugs, and my last two slides are the take-home messages. I always say when I teach tuberculosis, it's better not to treat tuberculosis than to maltreat tuberculosis. And this is a slide. This slide I used in Japan when I was in 1989. They asked me how TB is treated in India, please deliver a lecture. So I used this slide there. I still love to use that. If you don't give treatment, half a person of TB will die, one third will become sputum negative. Apne aap bhi theek ho jate hain, about 20% will be positive. If you give a good treatment, what will happen? Last line, manna bahut kam ho jayega. मेजॉरिटी लोग ऊंचाई से 100% ठीक हो जाएंगे. कुछ लोग, एक दो लोग को प्रॉब्लम हो सकती है 2-3%. लेकिन अगर आप पूरा इलाज लिख रहे हैं जिसका स्टडी है, थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड स्टडीज है, लैंसेट ने छापा, बहुत लोगों ने छापा कि पूरा इलाज का असर जो कि होता है, क्या होगा, डेथ रेट कम हो जाएगी, स्पूटम नेगेटिविटी बढ़ जाएगा. आप 10 दिन रिफैम्पिसिन यूज कर लो, आदमी नेगेटिव हो जाएगा. और लेकिन पॉजिटिव 27%, 18-27 में कोई फर्क नहीं स्टैटिस्टिकली. बट व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस, दिस 18 इज विदाउट एक्सपोजर टू ड्रग एंड दिस 27 इज विद ड्रग्स. सो चांसेस ऑफ ड्रग रेजिस्टेंस इज वेरी हाई. दैट इज व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इन द सोसाइटी. When we are badly treating these patients, this drug resistance is rising. So that's why the first message is not to maltreat, rather than don't treat. अगर आपको नहीं बढ़िया आता तो भेजो जिसको बढ़िया इलाज आता है. और मैंने वेट तो सब फ्री दे रही भाई. Well, effective use of drugs is very important message. Another message I always give, which has come into the international guidelines also. When you are treating tuberculosis. You are not, it is not like treating, many of physicians must be sitting, it is not like treating diabetes and hypertension. In diabetes and hypertension, what will happen? It will happen to the patient. But in TB, when you take patients of TB, you assume public health, important public health responsibility. And what public health responsibility? What I said in my first slide, when it is 100% curable, it is 100% curable when adequate drugs are prescribed and those drugs are taken also. So adherence and compliance, what you call DOTS, whatever you can say, is very essential. 1984, when I was lecturer in the department, rather I joined as a new lecturer in the department. And he did thesis with me, with Professor Mukherjee, and I was co-guide. I was a very small guy at that point. So I was co-guide, I still remember his, I still remember his thesis. Since then, so how many years? 84? To 2014, 30 years. So I am following him for last 13 years. Few of his qualities I can tell to you, which I have seen, which I have experienced. I have not seen a person who is such a hard working man. Well-read person. Inclination to learn. I have seen in last 30 years. And above all, a good human. That is, I think, the very essential quality one should have. You have heard about Dr. Sri Modi. He was a good human being. I met him many, many times. I found one thing, that is a good human. So above all, he's a good human being. And you know his popularity. Whatever I said nothing extra. I said what I really realized for him while following him for last 30 years.
Friend of mine for many decades, Professor B.P. Singh, the chairperson of today's scientific session, and my dear colleagues. At the outset, I would like to thank Kerala people for giving me this opportunity to share some of the things regarding innovations in the communicable diseases. The main emphasis would be on tuberculosis, and I would touch some of the salient points on malaria, dengue, etc. as far as vaccines are concerned. In the world, there are many disciplines of medicine, starting from homeopathy, naturopathy, Yunani, and to top all of them is allopathy. Perhaps the most funded, the most researched and the most practiced is allopathy. But if we ask ourselves as allopathic practitioners, what have we conquered amongst all diseases, all human suffering so far? Probably whatever we have achieved is mainly in communicable diseases. Otherwise, neurological diseases, psychiatric diseases, CNS diseases, endocrine diseases, we have not been able to achieve much as far as cure is concerned. We can replace the deficiencies. We can control some of the diseases like hypertension, diabetes, etc. But we cannot cure. We cannot make the person devoid of diabetes once he's diagnosed. So it is only communicable diseases wherein we can have some impact as far as cure is concerned. And that is why continuous innovations in communicable diseases are also always needed. In communicable disease or any other disease, innovations are required. For innovation, what is required is imagination, which is more important than knowledge. That is what Albert Einstein used to say. Anything that exists in the world today had existed in somebody's mind some years back. Then only it exists. Then the knowledge adds in the path of innovation. And that is why
one has to be full of dreams, full of imagination for doing better things in the world. Dr. Rajiv Prasad has made my work partly easy by saying what is the burden of tuberculosis, what is the burden of other infectious diseases. To touch mainly upon innovations in tuberculosis, I touched some of the things on diagnosis. Prevention I would not touch because it is perhaps the major responsibility lies with the government and they are doing their own job. And treatment part I will touch some of the newer things. And I will touch some of the vaccines in pipeline regarding dengue, malaria and HIV. This is what Dr. Ajam Sir has probably narrated, so I would not like to go into that detail. But a lot of people die of such diseases because of lack of proper treatment. These communicable diseases, the current gaps lies in the management of communicable diseases. And there is no cure for HIV and AIDS. There is no effective vaccine available for prevention of HIV, TB, malaria and dengue. A lot of people are dying. Lack of effective antimicrobials active against the resistant bacteria, mainly MDR and XDR, which Dr. Rajam Sir has highlighted. What are the biomarkers of bacterial infection that we use today? Probably the current biomarkers which we have been using in practice, mainly WBC count, which is high in bacterial infections. Sometimes we use C-reactive protein also. Less used are tumor necrosis factor, TNF-alpha, which is not being carried in all the laboratories. And very rarely we use interleukins, but they are more dependable. The newer biomarkers are lipopolysaccharide binding protein, LBP, which is being validated nowadays. Another is procalcitonin levels, which is now available in India in many laboratories. And still newer thing is exhaled volatile organic compounds, that is VOCs, for diagnosis of bacterial infections. To touch some of the things on prolactin, which is a novel biomarker, it is for the diagnosis of systemic inflammation, infection and sepsis. Serum levels of procalcitonin are elevated in response to bacterial endotoxins and inflammatory cytokines released during inflammation. Patients with bacterial infections have higher serum procalcitonin levels than those with non-bacterial infections, including viral. It's very good to differentiate it. And serum concentrations in healthy individuals is always less than 0.1 nanogram per ml. And this is the algorithm which is laid down in recently in July and December 2013, that prolactin procalcitonin levels, if it is less than 0.1, then antibiotics are strongly discouraged, must not be used. If it is between 0.1 and 0.25, then it should not be used. But then it depends on the discretion of the clinician. If it is 0.6, 26 to 0.5, then it should be used, it is recommended. And if it is more than 0.5, it must be used. It helps to differentiate between bacterial and viral infections. When you can do procalcitonin levels, elevated mortality in clinically ill patients, critically ill patients, and it helps judicious use of antibiotic. Sequentially, procalcitonin levels are an excellent guide to duration of antibacterial treatment. If it is very high, you can start with relevant two or three antibacterials also. And once it drops down, you can omit one or two antibacterials and continue with one only, depending on the levels. So it not only is helpful for diagnosis, but also for prognostic point of view. And the judicious use of antibiotic can be done. So that over-treatment of antibacterial therapy may be avoided. Exhaled volatile organic compounds, which is a newer thing for us, for all of us also, professors also. Different VOCs are exhaled in different diseases. And non-invasive test, it is a very non-invasive test. If you list all the tests from most non-invasive to most invasive, the most non-invasive exhaled breath, which can be taken anytime within few seconds. Exhaled breath comes condensed. induced sputum, bronchoalveolar lavage, bronchial mucosa biopsy, transbronchial lung biopsy, and open lung biopsy. We are going more and more invasive when we go down. So the most non-invasive is VOCs. Multiple techniques can be used to collect, detect, and analyze exhaled VOCs. The most used is gas chromatography, which is gold standard, and it is being done in India also now. Others are like electronic nose, and so many are in the developmental stage. Breath print also is taken, like different VOCs are exhaled in different diseases. VOCs, fractional exhaled nitric oxide, hydrocarbons, nitrogen, oxygen, or sulfur containing compounds are measured. And the potential clinical use is in the diagnosis of TB. So this will be one more armamentarium, one more weapon in the armamentarium for diagnosis of TB if it is validated properly. Cystic fibrosis, which is difficult to diagnose properly. Asthma and COPD, very chronic diseases, now considered as inflammatory diseases. And even non-inflammatory diseases, lung cancer, also can be diagnosed by VOCs. Particularly useful in children, where the other body fluids are difficult to take. Elderly patients, and even seriously ill patients. If we talk about innovation in tuberculosis, it was 1882 when Robert Koch discovered this TB bacilli. Right after that, chest X-ray was discovered due to skin test, BCG, and culture media. As far as medicines are concerned, it was streptomycin which was first discovered way back in 1943-44 by Boxman. And from 43 to 63, various antibacterials working on mycobacterium tuberculosis were discovered. But the problem started a little later when there was emergence of multidrug resistance somewhere in the middle of the 8th century, combined with HIV. And as far as newer diagnostic tests are concerned, perhaps the most useful today is introduction of gene expert. In diagnosis, the algorithm, right from infection, from mycobacterium tuberculosis to human host, then replication of bacteria causing disease, and then the immune response in the form of cellular as well as humoral. Various tests have been developed, and we'll go and touch some of them one after the other. Serological test, Dr. Rangamasaj is very rightly saying that yes, for diagnosis of bacteria, but what is the relevance in India? Can detect the humoral immune response, IgG, IgM, and IgA to mycobacterial tuberculosis. Currently, 1.5 million tests, mainly ELISA, are performed each year for diagnosis of TB in India. Now it is getting less. Approximate cost which is spent is around 825 million rupees per year. It is a great pharmaceutical economic loss to the country. Inaccurate and imprecise test, high risk of misdiagnosis, and is not recommended by any international guideline and not used in developed countries. And it has been banned in India also last year. But still, many kits are being manufactured or were manufactured in India by different companies. They were projecting the specificity and sensitivity to a tune of around 80-20%. But now, the recommendation is that not to use it. Not only not to use it, but even they have banned the import and sale of the TB serological test kits also in India. You can neither manufacture it, nor you can bring it from outside. The diagnostic tools which have been endorsed by WHO are, one is the liquid culture, BACTEC and others, automated detection of mycobacterium tuberculosis and MDR screening, that is the LPA online assay, which is very much available in commercially market also as gene expert, molecular line probe assay which can detect rifampicin as well as INH also by Eno, Lipa, RIF-TB. And then the last one is the strip speciation. Perhaps this presentation is the older one. Can somebody help me? Provide simultaneous diagnosis of TB as well as resistance to rifampicin and yields positive diagnosis in 99 to 100%. But we have to beware, as Dr. Rajam Sir says, that how useful it should be and what weightage you should give to that positivity or negativity. This is how it is done. It is fully automatic, almost no touch technique, and the results are available within 2 hours. It is particularly useful in TB patients with HIV co-infection and suspected cases of MDR cases. One more is the high MDR plus and MDR plus SL test, which are useful for diagnosis of mycobacterium complex and its resistance to rifampicin and or isoniazid, that is about MDR plus. But for XDR, it diagnoses also resistance to fluoroquinolone, aminoglycosides and cyclic peptides also. And the tests are, the results are available within 5 hours. So that is also, so you can, within hours you can diagnose MDR or even XDR test. Under development are other tests. This one is very much available in India but not very useful, that is IGRA. It is a blood test which gives cellular immune response to proteins that are specific to mycobacterium tuberculosis. It has very little value, only in pediatric age group. If it is positive, then it says that there is infection with mycobacterium tuberculosis and not after BCG. But it is advisable not to use it very much. Breath analyzer test, I said, which is very much in vogue now under validation. And this lipoarabinogen detection in urine, this was first rejected 20 years back, but now it is again gaining the momentum and it is again under validation. As far as vaccines are concerned, if you can look at the history right from 1976, when first vaccine was established for smallpox, and thereafter, quite a few vaccines are very much useful to eradicate some of the diseases. The last one was 210 when the cancer vaccine has been introduced in US. As far as infectious diseases are concerned, around 137 vaccines are under development for infectious diseases. Currently, TB vaccines in clinical trial are of two types. One is BCG replacement vaccine and another is the group of boosters to BCG vaccine. These two are replacement vaccines under trial, which can overexpress the protein from the mycobacterium tuberculosis, and another is the recombinant vaccine. Booster vaccines are again of three types. They are also again trial. In all, around 11 vaccines are the candidates for tuberculosis, out of which these two, MP85A and RS-422, are promising. Out of these two also, this one looks to be very promising. And is under multicentric multinational trial is going on, and probably by 2019 to 2020,
the results would be available of this multicentric trial, which is going on at many places. So we look forward to have a good TB vaccine by 2020. TB is a monster, HIV is another monster. Vaccine for TB is difficult, vaccine for HIV is still more difficult. And when it is combined infection, it becomes a new monster. New. To get the vaccine for both of them is a huge task. And but recently, Chinese researchers have developed a vaccine that acts simultaneously against Mycobacterium tuberculosis and HIV. This vaccine is currently undergoing preclinical studies. Probably that also would take around 10 years for the study to go. As far as medicines are concerned, the innovations are done either by changing the molecules or by changing its way of mechanism of action. I'd like to skip this slide. MDR TV, Dr. Ipsad has said. The treatment part also he has said, which is very difficult, lasted for a long time, around 2 years. The challenges for new treatment is, and what should we look for in a new or novel anti-TB drug? Faster acting so that duration of treatment could be shortened. See, we have shortened the duration from 1.5 or 2 years to 6 to 9 months. But still, the compliance is a problem even in that. And that is why we wish if the duration is still shortened to 4 months or 2 months. But for that, we need a very potent medicine. Different mechanism of action is desirable so that the development of drug resistance to the new drug is less and should be active against dormant bacilli also in the treatment of latent TB infection. These are the desirable things in the newer treatment. Quite a few new drugs are under development. There are certain groups, nitroimidazole derivatives, oxazolidine derivatives, substituted ethinyl amine derivatives, and aryl quinoline derivatives. Most of them are under phase 2 clinical and phase 3 clinical studies. The only one, the aryl quinoline, that is TMC207, named as midaquine. Dr. Saad has touched some of the salient features of this, which has been US FDA approved. But since it is not available so far in India, and just to prevent the indiscriminate use of this midaquine, the government is thinking, Dr. Ayyazav is part of that committee to decide when it should be made available and what guidelines should be developed. It is the first new anti-TB drug developed in the last 40 years. Research product of Janssen Pharmaceuticals, a division of Johnson & Johnson. And I had an opportunity to be the part of this trial initially, way back in 2007. It is the presented in a tablet form of 100 milligram, marketed under the brand name of Sirturo, approved by US FDA in December 2012 for MDR TB. But it can be used for susceptible TB also. The way of mode of action is told. Inhibits the growth of actively replicating as well as non-replicating drug sensitive as well as drug resistant. So it can be used for MDR cases, it can be used for susceptible cases also. It can be used for replicating bacteria, it can be used for dormant bacteria also. So the features are too good, only that we have to use it and see. There are no adverse drug interactions with other anti-TB drugs and there is no cross resistance with the any of the groups of anti-TB drugs. The dose is 400 milligram daily, it's 4 tablets a day in OD dose for first 2 weeks, followed by 200 milligram thrice a week for 22 weeks, total of 6 months.